You know? I mean, no woman wants a scrub, right? I don't really know what y'all listening to. I know y'all listen to that Cardi B shit. Shit's not for me. Yeah, so it's finally official. What was the date again? April the 13th in Atlantic City. I'm in there like swimwear. We've been waiting for this fight for damn near 2 years, right? But it's here now. Now, here's the thing. I understand that Christina Hammer is the underdog, but Lady Hammer can box. She's going to have to do a whole lot of motherfucking moving. And hopefully, Claressa Shields don't get caught with a flash knockdown like she did before. So this is going to be some high-level female boxing shit. And here's the thing. This is what I love about it. Is now we're in that era. Because the last female boxer I talked to was Katie Taylor. I've never talked in... We've, as a brand, as a company, we've never talked to... No, we have. Rob, my colleague over in L.A., got to Claressa Shields. And to Christina Hammer. Me, I haven't interviewed him. Interviewed either of them. But however, I have interviewed Amanda Serrano. I have interviewed Katie Taylor multiple times and was just talking to her a couple of weeks ago about how women's boxing, like these women, they got to pioneer. They can't keep letting these big fights, you know, or the female big fights marinate too long. You know, this right here was just a proper, you know, just enough marination. Right now, Katie Taylor, Amanda Serrano is marinating nicely in the oven. You know, and in the fridge, in the plastic wrap, the plastic baggie, and should you put a marination in there, the little juices. They say put it in the refrigerator for like 15 minutes if you really, really want to over-marinate. Or no, not over-marinate, but get it marinated just right. They say, you know, like leave it in there for a whole day. That way the juices and the marination gets into the meats. Anyway, I'm excited about the fight. It's the biggest, is it? Wait a minute. What's the biggest women's fight that can be made right now? I like Katie Taylor Hamaduchi. I like Cecilia Brackett's Katie Taylor, but Katie Taylor is saying 140 is pretty much her max. Claressa Shields, 154, there's some concern there. 147, I don't think she should go to 147. She can't, I don't think that's the right thing to do. I tried to interview her at, what was the last HBO Jacobs Derevyanchenko, but then I ended up looking like a fucking stalker weirdo because every time I tried to get to her, somebody would get her first. And then I'd be looking there like, damn. The last time I tried to get her, Jill Diamond had got her. Then I said, man, fuck it. I'm looking like a motherfucking weirdo following her ass around. But she has a very smart boxing mind. And don't get me wrong. When she first became a pro, I wasn't really feeling her because she was saying some shit that was a little bit. I was like, ah, you don't want to have that reputation. But then she cleaned that shit up. So now... she's known amongst hardcore fans as being educated. Like she's not a casual. She just don't be saying no dumb shit. In regard to Christina Hammer, she's starting to get more recognition over here in the States thanks to 360 Promotions. I didn't get a chance to check out her last fight. In fact, they did put a promo together for her. I don't know if I can use this music or not, but this is on the 360 boxing page. When was their fight? They had a fight. She just fought. Let me look it up. Meaning Hammer. She just fought last weekend, right? Yeah, on the 9th. Back over in Germany. Then they be doing the women on BoxRec wrong. She looks like a psycho killer mistress. But she is a fighter, so I guess she want to look intimidating and shit. Hey, let's watch this. We'll be right back. Yeah, this is the promo for that card she had fought on. I'm going to go back and watch that fight. It was over in just two rounds. So it is going to be for the IBF, WBA, WBC, and WBO. It's undisputed. From my understanding, she's co-promoted by Salida. Both of them okay, from my understanding, you know what? I got the damn press release. The main reason why I had to get this video out early is because I got the press release. Let me pull this. Y'all can't see it. Y'all can't be trusted. Y'all can't be trusted. Let me see who's promoting this. Because Hammer is supposed to be... She has been somewhat aligned with 360 Promotions, Tom Loafer. You know, Golovkin's current, former promoter. We're still waiting on that news. Oh, let me see. Let me see. Let me see. It's going to be on Showtime. We know that. It doesn't say. I don't have time to read. Maybe I'm missing something. Oh, yeah. Shields and Hammer is promoted by Salida Promotions. Okay, there you are. Christina Hammer, 24-0 with 11 KOs. That controversial fight she had against Sophia Mathis all those years ago. Kylie Reese, you may know her from fighting, moving up and down the weight. She fought out Cecilia Brockus, Tori Nelson, Michaela Loren. She's been making her bones out there in the 160-pound division for quite some time. Clarissa Shields, Femke Hermans on the last HBO boxing card. We was at that. Hannah Ronken, Hannah Gabriels. That was a very, very good women's boxing fight. Hannah Gabriels, I missed her last fight, unfortunately. That was fucked up. It's a video out here for this fight. Her fight against Sarah Dwyer. I got to catch up on that. I feel bad missing that fight. But... very good 154-pound female fighter. Let's see. Where we at? What was that? Damn it. Did I lose? What did I lose? Oh. Tori Nelson, Nikki Adler. You know, she's now... she hasn't fought since she beat Cornejo, right? Nope. She's got to get on the ball, sweetheart. You got to get on the ball. What's going on? One thing about women's boxing is they don't have a... the sanctioning bodies are not caught up like they should be. You know, they don't have a rankings. Like, for example, you know how I can go to my rankings on my website, fightview360.com. And where we at? You see how, like, the rankings are cohesive in regards to the WBC, WBO, IBF, WBA, et cetera, et cetera. The women's boxing don't have it like this, but the top 15, you know, all the way down. You know, everything is all over the place.